Dr. Sri here, I'm going to talk about mallet finger today. So when you say mallet finger, so basically, let us say you get jammed onto a table like this, or let's say a ball jams onto the tip of the finger. So the finger quickly bends like this. So it quickly bends forwards and thereby rupturing the extensor tendon. And thereby, when a patient presents to me, his finger will be like this, and he'll be unable to straighten his finger all the way. And this is called as a mallet finger. And let's say the person comes and sees me. So I'm going to get an x-ray to make sure that the person has not incurred an avulsion fracture. So basically a tendon has not pulled the bone away. So I'll get an x-ray for that. So these injuries can be treated with splinting. However, there's a catch. We want to splint this finger in extension. So basically keep the finger straight for 6 weeks straight. So at any point in 6 weeks, let's say if accidentally you bend your finger like this again, then we restart the clock and then 6 weeks starts again. So let us say I've got a mallet finger. I'll get a splint like this. It's called as a stack splint. And then, so let us assume that this is my mallet finger. So basically I'm unable to straighten that tip of the finger here. So I'm going to put the splint like this and going to keep that finger in extension for 6 weeks. But let us say if you decide that, you know what, this smells stinky and I want to change it. So you have to make sure that your finger never bends in that process. So basically the way I would do is that I would just go to a table like this, and then I'll just make sure that I'll keep my finger like this here so that it doesn't go into bending forward. So now I'll just take a soap and water. I'll clean the finger. And after that, again, with the help of someone, I'll just kind of like put the splint back so that my finger never goes into flexion, or basically never bends forward. Let us say you've done 6 weeks of splinting, and then if you still have a small extensor, like basically there's a small bend in the finger, you can still do splinting for 3 more weeks at night, and that should be enough. But let us say even after that, if you have a small extensor lag, and that should be okay. It does not cause problems in the long term.